Hi, I'm Duncan from Africola.
Richard Gunner from Something Wild.
And we're going to be talking about the differences between rangeland wild goat and farm goats.
So we've got a couple of examples here. They're only a kilo different in carcass weight, but they're pretty different goats.
Yeah, you can even just see the difference of the colours. So what is the difference really?
The way that they're managed is different. What they eat is different. A lot of rangeland goats, they probably only see a person once or twice in their life, whereas a farm goat is like sheep and cattle, where they're moved from paddock to paddock by a farmer.
But as you can see, the colour differences between the two, obviously that is a lot more worked. You can see it's kind of like a ripped, muscle.
And darker as well,
and dark,
isn't it?
Exactly. So that's our wild, and this is our farms, a lot lighter, fat.
Yeah, and this one, for that 13 kilos against 12, it's grown a lot more bone and size, but it hasn't put that meat on because it's grown much more slowly. So let's have a go at them. These guys are a little bit harder to get through all the joints as well.
Yeah.
A little bit older and tougher, the connective tissue forms up.
You can really see all that sinew.
There we go, our leg, look at the difference. So you got that bit of fat cover starting to form on the farm goat, where it's completely lean. And look how much longer this one is.
Shall we attack the back
Get
strap?
Get the back strap off?
Yeah.
Absolutely. So this sinew here is pretty tough along the top on this rangeland goat.
Yeah.
And there's not a lot of back strap here.
For me, I really enjoy cooking the leg and the saddle, and then using the neck. These make really good roasting cuts, but in regards to the wild, do you just braise wild goat?
Well, I'd pretty much
or?
Be looking at braising the whole goat. Off the wild stuff when they're but at certain times of year when the season's good, you can definitely get beautiful backstraps out of them, but you need to make sure that the goat has that fat cover before you're looking to try and braise. And
but you can also like make sausages and
that's for fun. Sausages and I'd use the backstrap off this, you use it in the kebab on the barbecue, work okay for that, but to do it rare in a fancy restaurant, it's not really the sort of thing that I'd be using.
Yeah. I find the texture also to be, especially on something as noticeable like the backstrap, be very different. Yeah, it's a lot more fat on this one.
Nice long one. But again, the colour difference, the deeper, darker colour. And then to see that, it's one of the other things you'll notice with an animal that's older and grown a bit slower is that sinew will be harder and thicker. So it's really important that before you serve that, you get that silver skin off. Whereas the silver skin on the farm goat, you want to take it off, but it's not as
important.
It's
not imperative for sure. And also the smell, it's way gamier, a lot more sort of metallic, a lot more.
So you need to be really careful with your spices, seasonings that goes with it.
If you soak it in milk, it takes a lot of that metallic flavor.
We have a huge range of customers that come and buy goat from us. The restaurants, we got a lot of the Indian and Nepalese and a lot of those cultures, and they'll make beautiful goat curries, and they're not fussed what cut it is. And then we might have the Greek restaurants, and they actually want the racks.
That's it,
side of things. There's an oyster cut shoulder. So taking that shoulder off with the oyster blade there. Generally, I think, again, you look to the cultures of where things are popular from, and so all those Indian flavours, they work so well.
Yeah, because I suppose it is quite acidic and it can take spices quite well, and it does really show through when you do heavily marinate it or heavily spice it. For me at the restaurant, I really enjoy roasting the leg and roasting the back strap. It just, it's a different type of protein. It's actually quick, for us to do in a service that we're not having a braised cut. Anything that likes to play on acid, whether it's stuff like, sumacs or paprikas or...
Sumac and goat, I reckon.
Yeah.
That's one of the match made in heaven.
That's it. But even the difference between the two shoulders, it's almost like two different animals, really. If you can see. So that's the wild and this is the farmed. Obviously there's a lot more meat on this shoulder.
I think this is probably one of the most, it's like looking at that colour of the inside of the ribs here between the two animals. It's,
Yeah.
You're really very, this is probably the starkest difference is this actual rib, isn't it?
Definitely. That's actually quite crazy. What we're going to do is we're going to go up to Tarasakota in Basket Range.
Beautiful wine.
Yeah, exactly, the best. I'm going to take the rangeland saddle, cook it over some charcoal.
Yep.
I reckon I'm going to grab the farmed leg, cook it in the bush oven. And the rest of this, I reckon some goat curry, some smoked ribs, and maybe some sausages.
Martin, clock on tonight and see if I can get some.
Well, with butchery work like that, mate, you've got a job.